time now for a Sunday morning Q&A. Joining us this morning, Dr. Joshua Sharfstein, the Secretary of the Maryland Department of Health and Mental Hygiene. Good morning. Thanks for coming in.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Hey, one of the things you wanted to talk to us about was the Healthy Maryland Week. What does that entail?
We had a great week. In the past, there's been Healthy Maryland Day. This time, there was Healthy Maryland Week. Mm-hmm. The governor and lieutenant governor were involved. We talked about opportunities for personal fitness and parks all around the state. We cooked some smoothies with some kids in Prince George's County. We talked about an important step forward for our initiative on health disparities. And then yesterday, there was an announcement about a wellness campaign for state employees.
Okay, and what does that entail?
It entails a bunch of things, helping state employees quit smoking if they're smoking, eat better, exercise a bit on the job, if possible, you know, walking upstairs where you can, as well as we're going to have some approaches to facilitating breastfeeding and other important things for health.
All right. You mentioned health disparities. That continues to be a huge problem, not just in the state of Maryland, but nationally. What's being done here in our community to bridge the gap?
In this recent legislative session, a pretty important piece of legislation passed to really start to make new strides on health disparities. Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown was extremely involved. Part of that is forcing the healthcare system to report how they're doing on health disparities, hospitals, insurers, really shining a bright light. It's not enough just to do good things for health. We have to make sure that everybody benefits. Second thing is there's a program with $4 million of funding called Health Enterprise Zones. And what this program is going to do is target resources to areas with very high disparities, because there's an irony in these areas. Even though you know, there's tremendous inequity, and for example, African Americans may have 3 times the emergency department visits for asthma, there's a lot of money being spent on health there. It's being spent too late. It's being spent after the asthma attack. That the idea behind this funding is let's flood some areas with funding and support and try to get people the care when they need it to prevent asthma attacks, for example.
Okay, and that's one example. I mean, we have so many things that are like that in the healthcare community. You take, for example, dialysis patients. If they were getting the blood pressure screenings and the other things addressed earlier on, they wouldn't be in that position.
It's absolutely right.
But why is it that we continue to spend money? Spend money to get them on dialysis, the federal government will, and local governments, but not to screen them ahead of time.
It's a waste. It's a great point. Our healthcare system is totally tilted towards dealing with complications and not nearly enough on prevention. Mm-hmm. So Maryland is really making some strategic investments in prevention. It's another important reason why we're moving forward to implement the Affordable Care Act, because we want to get people care when they are healthy so that they don't get that sick.
Okay, and so you mentioned that. So people need to keep in mind that don't just sit at home and not take your medicine or not get a checkup, because there are a number of resources for them to access those things at a reduced rate.
Everybody has, you know, responsibility for their own health. There are a lot of opportunities both to, you know, do what your doctor is advising, but also to eat better and exercise and things that just maybe aren't exactly medical things, but actually can be as important or more important for your health over the long run.
I guess what I'm saying is that there are programs to get you the medication you need and the screenings you need if you can't afford it.
That's true, although for a lot of people, there are real challenges, and that's why we're moving forward to implement health reform in Maryland so that everybody has that opportunity.
All right, the other thing, summertime brings special concerns, ticks, mosquitoes, West Nile. What is the concern with those things as we go forward into the summer?
So summer is just a great time for playing, for example, for kids, getting outside. But there are some dangers out there. We want kids outside, but we also want to make sure they don't get sunburned or dehydrated. They should be drinking enough and covered up or using sunblock. You got to be concerned about ticks because of Lyme disease in this area. It's very common. And particularly in wooded areas, it's important to be covered up, wear light clothes, inspect yourself or your children after going outside, and use repellent if necessary. So there's a lot. Pool safety is very important. You know, every year there are kids who drown in pools. All the time, you got to, you know, parents have to be vigilant about their kids and neighborhood kids.
All right, good stuff. Thank you so much for coming in, Dr. Sharfstein.
My pleasure. Do I get to ride the big wheel?
You do.
Okay.
Right after Ava.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you
so much. Next week, our guest.